everyone, Jen here with Next Wave Business Coaching. Today I want to talk about how to outperform your competition as a small business. I have four tips for you. So first of all, do you treat your competition like a whack-a-mole game? You know that carnival game where the mole pops his head up and you take the rubber mallet and as quickly as you can, you squash it? You know, understandably, we are competitive people by nature. And competition can be a positive behavior. It motivates you to succeed. However, putting all that energy into your competition can be unhealthy for your business and for you as the business owner, your mental state. And I learned this firsthand. I owned a children's consignment sales event business and started it with my friend and business partner, Sharon. The business was called Just Between Friends. And the business model was completely different than anything in our market. Up until we came into town, we had multiple mom sales in town, mom's expos, where moms would bring their children's gently used clothing and toys, and they would set up a table, they would price their items, they would sit at the table, they'd have to have their own cash, and they would sell their items. You know, a garage sale under one roof, if you will. Our business model was completely different. Twice a year, we would rent a huge venue, set it up like a temporary department store. Moms would price their items using our software program, bring them to us, we would hang them up on hangers and put them in sizes, and they would get a percentage. So when we first came to town, we had to educate moms on this entirely new process of selling their children's items, and we had to compete with all these multiple mom sales. So one day, my business partner and I were out delivering our promotional flyers. And we were distributing them all over town, and we noticed that one of our mega churches was having their huge annual children's sale. And we thought, well, let's let everybody know about us. So we started putting our promotional postcards under all the windshield wipers of the car. Needless to say, we were very embarrassed when the organizers of the sale called and asked us not to do that. And they didn't find that our way of marketing was very ethical and moral. So that brings me to tip number one. Instead of putting your energy and focus on your competition and trying to take away their clients, focus on your business and what differentiates you, your strengths, what you bring to the market, what problems do you solve? As it turns out, the moms that used our sale were a completely different target market. They were working moms than the ones that were using the other sales. So all that time and money wasted when we should have just been promoting ourselves and educating what we do different. My next point is understanding that you don't have to be everything to everyone. I think we get caught up in what our competition is doing and feel like we have to do that too. And I have a business owner friend who's a website developer. And I heard him say he takes his competitors out to lunch. Say what? And here's why. Not all web developers are created equal. What his strengths and who his clients are can be completely different than another. So he's building strategic relationships, and they will refer each other if it seems necessary. So it's also a great exit strategy, someone to maybe sell your business or to buy if you want to grow. So tip number two is define your target audience and then create your marketing message to speak to them. Don't worry about what your clients are speaking, competition speaking. Speak what your audience needs to hear. And then also tip number three, don't let your competition hold you back. Don't compare to them. I am learning that all things are not as they seem. You know, we live in the social media world of everything's all rosy, and we get so focused on what they're doing and how they're doing that it can bring our morale and energy down. You have no idea how they're really doing. Or how about you have no idea how much money they're really spending to attract those clients. They might not even be profitable. So when, you know, it's kind of like the person that always tells you what they win at the casino, but they never tell you how much they've lost. So I truly believe there's a bazillion people on this planet and there's clients for everyone. And you have your own unique skills that someone needs. Don't let a saturated market stop you. And then my last tip for outperforming your competition is it is important to be aware of your competition. You need to learn from them. If they're smart, they're learning from you. But don't get in a game of where's the beef. I don't know if you remember this 1984 ad, I'm dating myself here, where Wendy's hamburgers had little old ladies make fun of a hamburger for having such little beef patties in this big old bun. You know, we can all assume they were bashing McDonald's, right? This was wildly successful, and Wendy's grew their business 31% that year. However, they have the national brand recognition and the ad dollars to really bring awareness to a campaign, a luxury us small business owners do not have. Therefore, do not bash your competition, even if a potential client brings it up and has negative comments to say about them. Just tell your future clients what you can do, the value you bring, and the problems you solve. Take the high road, as my mom always said. Stay in your lane, and you will attract the clients that you're meant to work with. And it's going to turn out that this is going to be a lot more enjoyable for you anyway. We all want to work with people we're supposed to work with. So one of my six pillars to build a better business is to help you create a competitive analysis. Why do we do this? To make sure that we are maximizing all our opportunities for you. Not to steal their ideas, not to try to bash them, but just to make sure that we're pricing ourselves profitably and that we are offering everything that we can offer. So I invite you to message me if you would like to learn how to do a competitive analysis. I'm here to help. And in the meantime, I hope that you have a great day, and I'm here to help you take your business to the next wave.